Dinosaurs reigned on our planet for almost 200 million years. During this time, a huge number of species of these amazing creatures appeared and disappeared. Some of them, in the course of evolution, acquired unique abilities and acquired unusual external attributes. The purpose of some of them still remains a mystery to scientists. In this issue, we'll tell you about some strange and mysterious animals of the Dinosaur Age. Some of them have already been mentioned in our previous issues, while others we'll tell you about for the first time. Subscribe to our channel. This simple action will help you to be the first to know about the release of new videos. We also encourage our subscribers and viewers to comment more actively and mark their favorite videos with likes. This way, you can help in the development and promotion of the channel so that other science lovers can also learn about it. Dilophosaurus, a lizard with increased survivability that could not spit poison. In the first part of Steven Spielberg's film franchise, Jurassic Park, viewers were presented with a very strange small dinosaur that could spit poison several meters away. This creature was declared as a Dilophosaurus, but unfortunately, the appearance and unique abilities of this predatory dinosaur turned out to be fiction. Writer Michael Crichton, who created this book series, decided that when restoring the DNA of this species, the genes of one of the poisonous frogs were used. He also gave this dinosaur a chic leathery collar. In this form, Dilophosaurus models are now exhibited even in theme parks with moving dinosaur figures. And as an additional attraction, it pours water from its mouth on passing tourists. In reality, Dilophosaurus were completely different. They lived in the United States, and possibly China, in the period from 182 to 200 million years ago. Dilophosaurus got its name for a pair of small crests on its head. They were one of the largest predators of their time. They were about 7 meters long and over 2 meters high. They weighed up to 400 kilograms. But these lizards eventually discovered their own superpower. One of the skeletons found showed traces of 8 healed injuries. This indicates the amazing vitality and high regeneration rate of this species. Thanks to these abilities, the Dilophosaurus is listed in the Guinness Book of Records as the dinosaur that received the most injuries. Nothosaurus, fake lizards that lived like seals. The name of these reptiles, which lived almost all over the world for about 210 to 240 million years, translates as fake lizards. In fact, they occupied the niche of modern pinnipeds, and partly also crocodiles and turtles. It's believed that one of the groups of Nothosaurus became the ancestors of the already fully aquatic plesiosaurs. On average, Nothosaurus were 3 to 4 meters long, but there were specimens that reached up to 6 to 7 meters. These were semi-aquatic animals, perfectly adapted for hunting fish and other marine life. Their paws were equipped with membranes, and the teeth of the Nothosaurus had a pointed shape. Their mouth formed a kind of trap for prey. But these animals reproduced on land. There's an assumption that they laid eggs in the coastal sand, like modern turtles. Oryctodromius, a rabbit from the Cretaceous period. This species was the first of the described dinosaurs that were prone to digging holes. The fact is that in the USA, 3 individuals were found buried under a layer of earth. A more detailed study of the remains allowed us to assume that they died as a result of the collapse of their own hole. The size of the underground chambers and passages corresponded to the dimensions of an adult Oryctodromius. These were small ornithopods. Their body length was slightly more than 2 meters. They weighed about 20 to 30 kilograms. Their holes had a total length of about 2 meters. They also had side tunnels that were dug by symbiotic animals, that is, smaller creatures that used someone else's hole for safety and ate the remains of the lizard's meal. Moreover, these undoubtedly predatory dinosaurs did not have pronounced adaptations for digging the earth. Their front paws were not very thick. Scientists assume that they got food by running fast, and bulky front paws would only hinder them in this. This concept is implemented in approximately the same way in modern rabbits. They also live in burrows, but they don't have paws like, for example, a mole. Chaoyanosaurus, the first lover of nuts and seeds in history. A small dinosaur from China discovered at the end of the 20th century may well be the ancestor of all ceratopsians. Moreover, the giant descendants of Chaoyanosaurus, which lived at the end of the Jurassic period, are not at all similar to it in appearance or habits. The mass of this dinosaur was no more than 20 kilograms, the body length was 110, and the height was 70 centimeters. Presumably, it was a herding herbivore that moved on 2 legs. It did not yet have an impressive protective collar and long horns. Their place was occupied by small growths in the back of the head. but Chionosaurus became the earliest known dinosaur with a beak. Scientists associate the presence of this tool with the appearance of the first nuts and other seeds in a hard shell. It turns out that these dinosaurs had, at that time, the unique ability to crack seeds and nuts. Pegomastax, a cross between a parrot and a porcupine with a built-in tooth sharpener. There have been many strange dinosaurs created over 200 million years, but the Pegomastax can safely claim to be the creature with the most amazing appearance. Its head ended in a short beak and was similar to the head of a modern parrot. At the same time, the body of this small ornithopod was covered with either thin needles or long, dense hairs. Perhaps they served as protection from predators. This dinosaur lived in South Africa about 200 million years ago. It weighed no more than 3 to 4 kilograms and had a body length of about 60 centimeters. One of the most interesting external features of Pegomastax were 4 long fangs protruding from its mouth. At the same time, the dinosaur itself was an herbivore, and the fangs were most likely for digging up roots or cutting plant shoots. Their fangs were positioned in such a way that when the mouth was closed, they sharpened themselves. Lynchenicus, an anteater dinosaur that destroyed termite mounds with one finger. The small size of the forelimbs of large predatory theropods has long been a reason for the creation of memes. But the hands of the T-Rex and Carnotaurus look normal compared to what they turned into for the Lynchenicus. Although it can be said that this dinosaur did this consciously. It lived in China about 83 million years ago and belonged to the Alvarosaur family. Its body length barely reached 50 centimeters and it weighed no more than 500 grams. This baby ate various insects and termites. As a result of such a diet, it was forced to learn how to effectively destroy termite mounds and open thick tree bark. To achieve this, Lynchenicus's hands lost most of their bones. In fact, instead of hands, it was left with only one finger, which had completely turned into a claw. Ulsciraptor, a duck with flippers instead of wings. Around 2011, illegally mined samples of an unknown dinosaur's bones in the Mongolian part of the Gobi Desert ended up in private collections. Scientists were able to study them only several years later. This species was named after the Polish paleontologist, Olszka Osmolska. She was one of the leading experts on Mongolian dinosaurs. The researchers got their hands on a virtually completely preserved skeleton of this small dinosaur. This allowed them to conclude that Ulsciraptor occupied a rather specific ecological niche. It was a semi-aquatic fish-eating diving dinosaur. Ulsciraptor was comparable in size to modern mallard ducks. It had a streamlined body and a long goose neck. Its mouth contained a set of sharp, slightly curved teeth designed for catching aquatic inhabitants. It's believed that it could dive for prey to great depths, as modern penguins do. At the same time, the hind legs of the Ulsciraptor were quite long and thin. This suggests that the dinosaur moved very quickly on land. It was not possible for it to leave the shore forever. After all, like other dinosaurs, it laid eggs. Therefore, the Ulsciraptor acquired a unique feather for dinosaurs. For ease of swimming, it grew membranes on its front paws and used them in the water. Nigersaurus, a sauropod with replaceable sets of teeth. About 110 million years ago, a rather unusual lizard lived on the territory of modern Nigeria. It's considered a dinosaur with the largest number of teeth. Nigersaurus was discovered more than 50 years ago, but a more detailed description of this species appeared only in the late 90s of the last century, when more samples appeared for study. It was a classic four-legged herbivorous dinosaur with a long neck. Its length was about 9 meters, and its weight was up to 4 tons. Compared to its relatives, the sauropods, Nigersaurus was quite small, but it had some unique features. Firstly, its jaw was located across the head and was much wider than the facial part of the skull. Secondly, the teeth of this dinosaur were located in a kind of battery. Behind each of the front teeth, there were 9 more spare ones. As it grew older and its teeth wore down, Nigersaurus replaced them with new ones. Its upper jaw included 68, and the lower jaw, 60 such columns of teeth. These structures are also seen in hadrosaurs and ceratopsians. But Nigersaurus used more than 500 active and replaceable teeth throughout its life. This makes it a record holder not only among dinosaurs, but possibly among all other animals. We've reached the end of the video. As always, we thank everyone who watched all the way till the end. If you want to learn more about these and other amazing dinosaurs, we recommend that you pay attention to other videos we posted on our channel. You can also learn more about the evolution of other species of living organisms, the characteristics of modern animals, and the problems of human society. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one!